Okay, we're doing a little experiment with the Mohs in here. 9130. Got my bayonet. I was watching a movie that was made in Russia in 1975 or 74. It's called, I think they fight for their land or their motherland or something. It's a Second World War movie that follows like a platoon of Russian soldiers in like a rear guard action during like the initial part of like Operation Blue or whatever in southern Russia there. The operation ended up turning into like Battle of Stalingrad and all that kind of stuff. But anyway, it follows them and some of them have 9130s, and a whole bunch of the Russian soldiers in that have the bayonets put on backwards. And I know this was a common practice for these guns when they were being transported in trucks or other enclosed areas. And but they were firing them like that, which I believe is probably not going to work, because they're shooting blanks in the movie, obviously, so the I'm pretty sure the bayonet will fly off, but because it doesn't lock when you put it on backwards. But I was just thinking, if I can, if it sort of comes loose every time when I shoot it, I'll just try it out and see what the impact is at 100 yards with the bayonet on backwards, to see if the blade sticking out forward has something to do with helping it shoot where it's supposed to. Because normally, you know, it'll shoot like high right without the bayonet. I've done shitloads of tests on that. The majority of 9130s do that. They shoot like high right, like 12 inches high. And then they shoot pretty close to point of aim at 100. Depends what your front sight is like, because when they refurb them, they get them all screwed up. But anyway, we'll stick the bayonet on, and I don't have a tripod, so we're just going to have to kind of deal with it here. And we'll get the target and take a look at it. If there's background noise, that's they're doing some work on the parking lot, so. But anyway. Jammed on there. Let's see how. Let's see how this works. Probably go flying off first shot. I'm trying to get five shots. I'll have to stick the bayonet on it every time or something. Does loosen it. It makes a weird wobbly vibrating noise. You're vibrating in the stock. Yeah. Maybe two shots would dislodge it. Took it off. Yeah, it don't work too good. anyway, we'll get the target and see what the croup is like, see if it shoots high or shoots sort of. But that's not going to work. You can't shoot him with a bayonet on backwards. Dislodges it pretty quick. Be right back. This is actually kind of interesting. So it's aiming here. Normally, without the bayonet, you'd have all the bullets up here somewhere. With the bayonet on, they sort of go here, you know, right around where you aim. But with the bayonet sort of ass backwards, they sort of go halfway. Got four here within a pretty damn small group. And the fifth one, that's probably the one where the bayonet flew off, but so kind of interesting. But yeah, it's not really a viable thing to do. Like if you took, I think you took the part that locks on the gun and chopped the rest of the bayonet off, you'd probably end up with something like that, sort of halfway between kind of deal. But I think that time when the bayonet came loose, the friggin' thing wobbled so much it just sort of threw the round. That's more or less where they end up if you don't have the bayonet on. I just shot five without the bayonet and five with it. See where they go. Maybe I'll mark this and I'll try that to show you the difference. Okay, so this is pretty much what I said. With the bayonet on, you get group here. It's, you know, a few inches high. I was aiming about here. Tiny bit off center, but that's just windage on this front sight. It should be a pretty good groove. We got three almost touching, and then that's pretty good for sights on the Mosin. Then you got the group with the bayonet on backwards. You got four here, and then one went up there. And here's your group with no bayonet. And from this group to the group with the bayonet is, there's 12 inches from both the center to the center of the groups. This one here is 6 inches. It's sort of, windage is a little bit more to the right, so it's kind of neat anyway. So putting the bayonet on backwards gets you about halfway to where you should be, but anyway, it's kind of cool. So put your damn bayonets on, guys.